Hello and nice to meet you to this new Weekbit show. On the bench we have a CD player from Philips. I think so it's 35 years ago then I bought this CD player, not this exactly model, but this is a CD473. You can see that here. And now let's have a look. First, the dust test. we need to clean it up, and this is the first step where we start. This is not Kleenex, this is clean air, gas cleaner. we do that in the first step because I don't would like to have that my fingers are dirty. And long time ago, this is on storage. And you can see it's a lot of dirt. It's not perfect, but for the first step, it's okay. Yes. Cleaning also in the corners, and the buttons, they are dirt from the fat fingers, chocolate fingers, and so on. Oh, here we have the first defect. Look, this is here we have the thing. What's defect here? This volume control is defect. Phone's volume, as for the iPhone. Extra, but it's broken. Just like this. Oh, what we're gonna do first? We have make a test. Making this. Interest. It opens, and today I have made the Weekbit CD audio with 28 titles and. 10 from them are from the free music library from Netflix, and I asking him that he can borrow me his music and so on. It's in the free library, but I would like to also have a discussion with the musician what I'm playing and so on. We do that now only for testing, test purpose, and error. It's an error. Could be that this cannot be read. This is interesting. Next step, I would like to test it with a CD curing concert. Maybe it cannot read the self-burned CDs. That's a problem. Oh, that works. But I think not so good. We must open it and have a watch what's under the hood. So let us do this. Stop and eject. Self-burn CD cannot be read. This is interesting because I burn it very slow, only maximum 16 times. So I don't understand why it is so. For this Philips CD473, we have a special tool. This is the focus. Where is my focus? This is a star screwdriver from Philips, or Philips T10. The number T10 is here. It can't be focused sometimes, but yeah, I'm very sorry for that. It looked like a star. Yeah. Switch it off in case of electricity hazard or shock. And now we open it up. It's quite heavy, this machine. So I open it up now. Here is my screw holder. Yeah, Royal Mail, made in England. put it every screw in a volume like this, because the reason is that we cannot search the screws after repairing or after reparation. So you found all in one compartment. Wow, what's inside here? What the hell is inside here? Unbelievable. Plasticky sink. So we must open up the screw for the front side, and this is important to come into this part here, in the front of here, of this volume control. We must left screw this better. You can see the screw. I must take it here and hit it inside here. So we open up this. Oh, it's interesting. I think we must get this away from here. Aha, there is a schnappy. A special schnappy. I don't know. Ah! It's brutal. I think so, it's defect now. Here it is. CD player, compact disc, filter in 16-bit DA conversion, 4x oversampling. Okay, that's good. That sounds good. What are we gonna do here now? We must... It's interesting. It's snapped. Snapped in. It's a snap-in mechanic. But... here. We can open it. You must do that with feeling, because the plastic is now 35 years old or so, and that means it's complicated. First, should we repair this? But here is the screw diameter is much smaller, and is also this star screwdriver what we need. Okay, we do that. But I must find screwdriver like this. Well, this screwdriver is a T7 Phillips screwdriver, and these screws are very small, really small. I hope so you can see this. Put it a little bit more in the center, and we must open up this to repair the volume control for the phone headset or phone set, and interest what's going on here. I think it's easy to understand what we happened here. It's only pressed out. We must snap it in. It's very easy. But if it's open, we can do also the contact spray, contact 60, and contact 60 for the other camera. Contact 60 from Contact Chemie, and you can use also that the American ones or Asian ones, and only a little bit. Because if you put it in too much, look, we must make a training. We are doing the training for the old machine, and that should be help in front of crackles in the sound on the ear headset. Yes, that we're gonna do here. And after this, we must reinstall this. We must reinstall this. So we put it over and found out where is the potentiometer. Snap. And now look. Ha ha ha. Very nice. Very smooth and nice. I hope so it's calm during the regulation and not so extreme distort. Now we close this special thing here, and that was the first step what we must repair. And these little tiny screws, unbelievable. I don't know why they making productions like this. They don't have a long edge where they insert the thing, the PC preprint. I don't know why they do this. So you can see that's fixed. The first issue is fixed. And now we would like to also clean up the fluorescent display. It's under here, and that means we must open this. So with another screwdriver, I remember number 10 was a good, yeah, they use number 10. This is number 10. I changed this from here to the number 10, and good. We would like to recycle the display, and in case of that, we need to unscrew this. Oh, in case over temperature of my camera. Oh my gosh, this camera. What shall I tell you? Sounds to be a little bit crazy. Here we have a, I forgot this. Hope so it's not defect. I forgot this screw here. So slowly. Aha, wonderful. You can see it. So we said that we would like to deinstall the mechanism. And for this case, I must unlock this screw here. Oh, short ones. And here this one in the center of the drive. Disconnected from the power supply. What's happened now? Here. So one screw. A long one. What's happened here? Jesus. Here we are. You can see that. This long one. Interesting. This plasticky thing. It's a horror. I don't realize where we have the oh my gosh, this is very, very crazy. The pincet. What is this? It's a holder. There is something on, maybe on the bottom. Yeah, it is here. You can see it. It's here. You put really screw from downsize. It's also the long one. Okay. Okay. And now we can lift it. Aha. Uh-huh. But it's this motor we must disconnect from the rest of the motherboard. And here we have gonna here. Oh my gosh. It's a flex PCB under it. How they construct this. Hey, come on. This engineer don't think about the service people. So you cannot believe it's under it. And you cannot go there because it's under it. Okay. There is a capacitor. Aha, zack. And here we open it. Ah, sus. Look at this. Here is the flat PCB. Look. Is that worst? I cannot laughing. So here we have the drive. It's a swing drive code like. Look, that means the laser is not running like this, it's running like a circle, a part of a circle. It rotates over this point. Interesting, huh? Laser lens is dirty. Oh my gosh, oh so dirty, all dirty. But this schnappy is interesting. It's a special schnappy, look. Look at this mechanism, this is super cool. Look on the side. The CD tray is now here in the CD. You see it? It's in one edge, yeah? And if you drive it in, it lifts down, yeah? You see this? Look, up. Ah. Zack. It lifts down. This is super. This is a super mechanism. Yeah, a lot of ICs here on the motherboard. Here is the connector for the flat PCB. And let's have a zoom. Camera is zooming. It's a little bit, it's interesting. What's going on here? Typical, the plastic thing. The plastic thing here. You see this? This is the power switch. The remote control for the power switch. ICs here. L272 is an amplifier. Haha. Uh-huh. Here we have the TDA5708P. And so on. I hope so you can see this in 4K. But I bought the camera new and maybe. You can see this. This is interesting. So that IC MAB8441. Uh-huh. Maybe this is a duck. Or is it? Isn't it? Maybe there's another duck. SAA7210P. Uh-huh. So interesting. We also built out all the things. What happened here on the back side? And these are mechanical things now. It's not so interesting, but what is this? The mechanical things are here. So that's the thing is here. Build out this board. I would like to build out this board. Uh-huh. Doesn't work so good today for me. But I don't know why. Uh-huh. It's a thing that. Uh-huh. Ah, it's very easy to understand how this is snapped in. Look at this. First, we snap out this and then snap out this. So we have this. I don't know what's doing. It's an amplifier. Oh, it's the analog outboard boot. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now we must rebuild all out. And let's do this. So I must deinstall this. Oh, very long screw. Mm-hmm. They cannot save money with this transformer. Interest why they putting it here. Uh-huh. It's gone. Look at this. Full of dirt. We must have a clean for this. We must clean it. For this reason, to change these electrolytic capacitors, I ordered here a new one. It's a 6800 microfarads and 16 volts or so. Let's have a look. Really? 16 volts. Focus. Here we are. Soldering iron is hot, like 370 degrees Celsius, and we put us this here and here. What is this? yes, 12 volt leads told me I should not change it, I should measure it, and I said time is money, we don't measure it, we change it. Because after 35 years of living, it's not a must that this electrolytic capacitor is defect, but you don't want to have it back. And so if it's dying not today, it's dying tomorrow. And this is the answer of all this, because this electrolytic capacitor costs like 80 cent or $1.80 or €1.20 or so, I don't know. It's hard to take our best friend the acetone. Here we are, acetone, and clean up this. Boah, it smells like a chemical industry. What the hell? Unbelievable. Adrian, this is for Adrian Black. You should sniff on this. That frees everything in your nose. Oh God. That worked. I hope so the tires are not dying if they smell this. It's really hot. But don't clean the plastic with this. Never clean plastic with this. Everything is destroyed. And put it away. Look, it's yellowing and my fingers are death now. This is the smell of death. Believe it. You cannot. Also, we must doing the in case of this, we doing 105 degrees Celsius inside, and this is the 1000 microfarad, but this 35 volts from Sheng X. Sheng X is a very big company. You cannot see it because it's so big. Yeah. And we would like to solder it in. It's very simple. My soldering iron. Okay. Okay. It's not the best soldering joint, but okay. Also, we must have a watch on the downside in case of the cold soldering points. So we insert this in the correct direction. Plus and minus is here. Super. And solder it in. Don't insert it in the wrong direction. And hold it up, making click. That means it stands on the floor of the PCB. And there we cut the cutting this. Put it away. And then we have a watch on cold solder joints. Cold solder Phillips is the inventor of the cold solder point. Here we have one. You can see it. This one looks like here. It's around a small ring. This is a problem. Because the whole print, this is not so bad quality, really. I remember it was a long time ago, it was much worse and so on. And they, but here you see this ring? Focus. You see this ring on the solder point? Maybe you see it. This is interesting. You can see it here. You have a ring around this, and this is broken. That means we must resolder it to close this problem. Let's have a look on the drive. First, we clean up this with this drive a little bit. Then we must change this belt. You can see it here. It's for the load mechanism. I think so we can. This is a funny spring, look. Put it here. And then we take out the motor. We can clean it also. What's happened here? Where is the holder here? This is dead. This is the holder. This is the holding mechanism. Oops. Help! Hey, look at this. It's a one. It's a one screw installation. If you loosen one screw, all is falling apart. No joke. Okay. I put this out to reinstall it again on the on this. This is the holder, the upper holder. Okay. Spring. Here is also one spring. Don't lose the spring. Here are the springs. Don't lose them. Okay. Here we have the defect ring. Look. You can see it. Yeah, now you can see it. This small interruption in the gum, in the rubber. Yeah, yeah. Okay, we take a new one. I ordered it. We take the belt box. Oh, what's happened here? 4,700 microfarads. We'll take the belt box. Look. What's happened? 100? Too big. I think it's 80 or so. No, 80, 90. 90. Eventually, 90. But this is too, not so thick. 80. 80 is 80. It's super. I take a 80. It's a little bit stronger, but okay. Watch this. And also so, not thick. I hate it. This day written is 1 millimeter, but this is not 1 millimeter. This is a 0.5 millimeter. But what shall I do now? I can order original one? No. There are no spare parts exist anymore. We take this away and okay. Can this now? This now, and I have an idea. I built in a motor first. Built in the motor first. Why not? Do you remember this crazy? Why? What's that? What's happened? Aha! Interest. Look here, we have an edge, and this must be inserted here exactly. Not that you can. That means with this you hold the position from the motor in torch. Okay, so we have this, and now. We must also have a watch on the spinning that the belt is correct running. That means it runs in the same position in then here out, yeah. Because it's quarter edged. I hope so. This cord like quarter edged, but here. We're doing that what the Phillips girls are doing. They insert this 1,000, 100,000, million often times. Unbelievable. So what we're gonna have here is the we should give them a clean, huh? That looks like dirty. Well, my Sony camera is overheating. I don't know why so often. What shall I say? I bought it as new one, not used, but nobody told me that this is so bad. That clean up this, that this temperature problem have. It's a set V1, but the temperature problem makes me crazy. This is not normal. I must asking Sony what's happened with this. Maybe they need a new firmware update, or is it not allowed to film so much 4K videos? This is also possible. Look at this. Now it is clean, a little bit cleaner. I insert the drive now and hope so I can connect it. What is this for a connection? On the switch, the tray from the drive is in. You understand? It goes in, means it's in. The controller see that's in. Oh, here is a dirt. I clean it. So, super.
It runs well.
We installed these here. Also, special super thing, this plasticky thing, and the long one. Click, click, sounds good. It's here, and one I installed here. That here was a screw. So, super. This PCB flat cable is also installed. We hope so, it works. In front of we must have this, and here we connect it to here. The connectors are colorized clip connectors from Philips. I think so they invented for fast insertion or stuff like this. This we also can do insert here. But now the complicated thing is this complete plastic. What shall I say? It's crazy, and it's like this. What's happened with this? It's crazy. But you don't have it, so. Our camera is overwhelming. This should be fixed the issue. I hope so. There are three screws. I installed it now, and let's have a watch. It's a burnt CD. Normal, this player not reading burning CDs. Well, it reads. Cool. And now play. Jump to the 9th position. Listen. Cool. That sounds good. Jumping the track. Cool. What I must doing is a little pull up the laser energy. It was a must that I align the diode. The monitor diode, and sounds not so bad for this old machine, 35 years old or so. In this case, I repaired the CD473 and from Philips. electrolytic capacitors, wear defect, little bit, not so much. we can measure the ESR, that's correct, but I don't do that because I change it because that €2-3 these Elcos, and it's not the way to do this. Then the belt was defect, and also the current of the laser, the monitor diode, I push a little bit up. So if you are interested in this, then please subscribe or sponsor me by Patreons. And I'm doing the next time video, not video repair, but on video I repair CD players. If you're interested, I also making the old things to work, if I got spare parts. This is the problem. And thank you for watching.